That should be the best, I think. We have a really odd team. I don't know, we've got a really good poke comp here with a Sona for the disengage whenever the enemy team wants to mess with us. We've got great poke on Caitlyn, me, and Jace. So we can siege really easily. We can't really split too easily, and the enemy Nasus is going to be a pretty formidable force for that. She's definitely going to smoke me out here with a good Q. She's going to be sitting in that brush just waiting. I'm kind of annoyed that nobody actually warded this dry brush, so I'm going to do that myself. This is something that should never be forgotten. This dry brush has got to have a ward in it. Come on, guys. Alright, cool, 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 cool. I will guide you. Gank for me. Oh my. The demands are already. I'm gonna gank who I find to be the easiest gank. Get the hell out! Jeez, people overstay. She didn't want to. Like, why would you stick around, Sona? What are you doing? So, her sticking around actually almost denied me the ability to clear that camp safely. I didn't want to risk giving away half the experience and being locked out at level 1. There she is. There's the typical cheese. I found you, babe. Found ya, you freaking cheesy little butt. I bet you she's either gonna go back to base underneath tower. She didn't go to wolves. Okay, cool. So I know she didn't do her blue buff. She tried to cheese me. Let's see, where's Cassiopeia? She's not coming down. As long as I caught her on the cheese, I'm happy. People like to do that too frequently. It's very bizarre. As Vi, you should not be doing that. Never. That was really, really stupid of her to try that. The reason for it is because, like, I'm Nidalee. Early game, for some reason, this computer is so disorienting to play on. But for Nidalee, early game damage is not a problem. It's your late game dueling pressure that's not really. It's your mid game, really, is the biggest fault of Nidalee. Her late game is pretty decent. Wow, this is such an odd setup. I need to switch this scaling back down to 1900 by 1080 or something, because this is just, it's too weird. I'll do that after I go back and I'll see how it looks. I feel like it's just too zoomed in and it just feels so weird. I'm guessing that Vi might try to cheese here, but at this point I'm already level 3 and she's not even got her blue buff or her red buff, so she just grabbed her blue. I just caught her out, so I know she doesn't have a red buff. What we can do is we can meet her at her red, even though I have this weird janky thing to deal with. We don't have to worry about it too much, so I'm gonna guess that she's gonna go this way. So we can go just wait for her and mess with her. I'm guessing that she's gonna go around. I'm not ganking Nasus, there's no way. This guy's pushing in too hard. This is not gonna happen. Where the heck is Vi? I say, she's gotta be nearby. I probably didn't need to flash there. I probably could have just gone over the wall with a regular pounce. But I wanted to flash just for security's sake. I know Cassiopeia is coming up to mess with me, or at least there's a threat of her, so I'm going to take the exit route this way. But Vi, with her stupid cheesiness, I just wanted to make sure she knows that I will beat her up as soon as possible, and that she's got to stay the heck away. So after this camp, I'm going to go back and I'm going to try to fix this resolution, because it just bothers me so much. Go video resolution to this. Okay. Oh, that's so much better. Thank you. Jeez. Might look uglier. It's gonna look so much smaller on the screen. So I don't know. I'll have to work with the streaming part, but it looks better now. For me. Let's see. I want to upgrade this. So just give me some time here. Unfortunately, for those of you who are watching on the stream and maybe on YouTube, it's going to look a little bit weird. I'm sorry. It's a new computer. I haven't set this one up for streaming yet. This is like the first time streaming on this computer, and it's really awkward looking. So, wow, he got away. Good for him. But it's going to be really difficult for me to set it up while I'm playing the game. Vi is... Dude, come on. Use your brain. Don't do it. Don't do it, you idiot. He actually managed to pull off a kill. All right, and never mind. Take that back. Although it was still really stupid. I don't think he should have done that. If Vi had actually used her knockback into her E, she would have two-shot him. Her E does quite a bit of damage, although she was level 3 while he was level 6. That's a pretty significant advantage, but it's not significant enough for me to say, you know what, you should just turn on her, because I think she was so far, he was so low, that it was just too risky to try to turn that. But, you know, that's just my personal opinion. Sometimes my opinion is a little too conservative for some people, sometimes it's a little too aggressive. Everyone has their own playstyles. Please, Jace, let's kill this bitch. Bloop. Taken care of. So she kind of missed the ult portion. I was waiting for her to look directly at me so I could turn on her. Like, turn away from her, and then she couldn't stun me, but she didn't even use it on us. I don't know if she's just spacing out or if she just didn't have the ability to turn on us and actually land a good ult. Had she ulted a little bit earlier while I was coming in on her, she probably could have stunned me and prevented a lot of the damage. Or she could have even ulted Jace and prevented some of that damage as well. Yeah, that was kind of sloppy. I would say could have been played a lot better by Cassiopeia. Cassiopeia, or however you pronounce it. Whatever. Oh, there's a reward right here. Cool. Thanks, bro. Free ward. As I say, they should know exactly. Like, I'm not going to ping for Vi's position there. My bot lane should be fully aware of where Vi is and what she's doing. There's my level 6. Nasus is most likely going to teleport. Wait, is there a ward here? No, it's not. As I say, did I just walk past the pink without even getting any heads up on that? Am I really that dumb? Vi has not cleared this guy yet, interestingly enough. Alright, cool. Let's go ahead and just clear out her topside jungle. Punish her a little bit for being Vi. There we go, boys. Ho ho! Good stuff, dude. So Cassiopeia came up to save her friend Vi, and then unfortunately for both of them, they ended up dueling us each, and we both had a significant advantage. I am not gonna gank the top lane, dude. You're pushed into the second tier tower where I have no gank opportunities, and we can't siege it. There's no way I'm gonna dive that, dude. What are you thinking? Like, good job taking the tower earlier, but I don't know what you expect out of me. So I am rushing max cooldown reduction. I got 5% in my masteries, and I'm deciding to pick up a Lucidity boost. This is something I've been doing recently. I don't know why, just it makes it more fun. It makes it more fluid. It doesn't necessarily make me stronger or weaker or anything. It's just a different build path, and it just makes it more fun because I can spam abilities in cougar form more often. It makes it feel more, like, more fluid, like I said earlier. But unfortunately, the internet here is still a little bit janked. I've got to figure out what the situation is on my internet, but it feels a little bit less than perfect. And as a result, like, I feel a lot less awesome at the game. I feel like there's just a slight lag between my interactions and like the actual stuff going through. So like whenever I press a button, I feel like it takes too long. But whatever, we'll deal with it. It doesn't hurt the game too much. We're still doing all right. But at this point, we've got a significant lead. This is where you don't say, all right, we've got a significant lead. Let's just go ahead and like cuddle up and just wait. That's not the solution to having a lead. Or that's not what you do once you get a good lead. You don't just sit there and say, all right, we got a good lead. Let's sit on it. You say, let's make this even more painful for the enemy team. We have a good lead. Let's make sure we stomp them. Because if you don't notice, the enemy team has a godlike late game. Like, they're not going to reach that late game for quite a long time because of the amount of damage we've done to them, but they can still reach that late game fantasy if we give them breathing room. So the biggest thing is, don't give them breathing room. Go kill Vi when she tries to do her blue buff here, and that's what we're going to do. Or apparently we can completely whiff. Alright, interesting. So Annie hit level 6. Vi didn't. Your team has destroyed Pokemon. That's what I thought, bitch. Wait, there's no turret here. Well, that sucked. He can kill her as long as he gets a good knockback. Oh, baby. Ah, oh, dang it! Why is Annie everywhere? Holy crap, and she got level 6 off of that. That's unfortunate. So the two things I'm going to do, I'm going to build this and I'm going to build this. I'm going to work towards the Negatron cloak into an Abyssal because they do have Annie and a Cassiopeia that I don't want to deal with. Too much damage. But yeah, this Annie has been kind of ruining my day. I mean, we took the bottom tower. She should be able to roam in her own jungle, but I don't know where our bottom was, and that's something I can't control. I can't get upset at our bot. I can just call them numbfucks or dimwits or something, and that's their fault. Caitlyn wins this one hard. I don't know why she ran away there. That was a waste. Probably didn't even need to do that. She could have just walked up and autoed. And he's got a low movement speed. Although Caitlyn does too. If she had used her caliber net onto her and then did that, we would have been even better off. So I'm actually picking up the super when I don't want to be. I usually don't pick up the super this early. The hell? Screw you and your wards. There's a ward right here. Alright, we're going to go ahead and put this right here on the edge of the bush so you can actually see into their jungle a little bit. Helps. She just got... Holy crap, it's too much damage. It's so broken. Even he goes, holy shit. Oh man. Well, I got a max range spear and a full combo, which is kind of awesome. So our Renekton's doing a great job of pressuring top lane. There's not really any need for me to make sure that top lane's underwater. Like the enemy Nasus. But I might as well go give him a visit and see if he can't take that tower. Oh my goodness, did he really walk away from that? And Nasus is dead here. Unless for some grace of ridiculousness, this guy walks away. Oh my gosh. There, I was gonna say, come on. Where's the damages? Vi already died, so there's no risk here. Cool. You just walk away. 1940. I can pick up the Negatron cloak and then go into a blasting wand. And then from there we'll see. I'm gonna switch back to this. Sell these two, and we're gonna pick up this the Vision Totem upgrade just because I prefer that. Yeah, Renekton's gonna stop bitching, alright dude? I get it. You're playing a 1v1 situation. Occasionally you get ganked by a Vi when you're this deep here. I can't make you ward. I can't teach you to not be dumb. Please, don't blame me, man. You're way deep in the enemy territory. Don't act shocked when all of a sudden you get ganked. I would gank even though I'm pretty much completely ignoring you. If the enemy Nasus is this deep, I would gank that shit. Like, you're pretty much giving them free stuff. guy's being a jerk over it too. So we got him muted already. We'll just report him after the game for being a nuisance. Not really being toxic, but he's being annoying as shit. He wants help. He wants help. What a shock. Is he aware that the enemy Vi is going to show up out of nowhere? Is he? Alright, cool. So he decided to force an engage when he shouldn't have. He's gonna say, Nidalee, why weren't you there? We'll unmute him so we can see him blame me for this lost fight. Say, Nidalee, why weren't you here helping me out? Rip. Oh, this guy, he forces a fight way before I could go anywhere near his lane. I guarantee he's gonna say, Nidalee, all your fault. Or something along those lines. If he doesn't, then he's got better restraint than he's been showing. Oh, thanks. Coolio. Later, girls. I think I can finish Abyssal soon. Yeah, I can finish Abyssal here. I'm not really being too frugal with my mana. I really don't care where I spend it if I'm spamming on camps here. Because I picked up this tier, I've got a very big mana pool. I'd rather just clear camps as fast as possible and have the ability to help out my team, especially because I have a blue buff as well. There's really no point in me not using it for useful things like showing up and helping my team out. So I might as well clear camps and get there just a little bit faster. Interesting. New tactics. I like it. There we go. So they go all in on like what? An Annie stun? That wasn't so smart. We get a free kill there. We get a free ace almost. Nasus didn't get... Nasus was there, I believe, but he didn't get anything out of it. We didn't lose any teammates, so they blew everything on me and I just walked away. Now Nasus has no magic resist, so he's pretty much dead. Oh my goodness. Their whole team is just baiting me to go all in. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and grab this sucker. Yes, I blew smite. It doesn't really matter though, I had two smite charges. It'll be back up in a short while. What's up, Komachiki? How you doing? Sorry, I just now noticed that you said hey. You said the return, actually. You didn't say hey. Yeah, sorry, I have the chat on a completely different computer screen, so I have to turn my head like 120 degrees to actually read the chat. So I'm sorry if I don't read your messages right away. Kind of the problem with having only one screen for a single computer. But that's alright. But yeah, this game's going pretty well. The biggest concern here is probably going to be Cassiopeia, but I don't think she's too much of a problem. Nasus, he's gotten pure armor. He's gotten very, very little health, very little magic resist. I'm not too worried about him. I'm pretty sure I can full combo him and do like 80% of his health from a combo. So if that's the case, then no problems whatsoever. Let's see, unless he built... No, he still didn't build any magic resist. What are you doing, Nasus? You're trying to stack. It's not going to work out well for you. You got 250 stacks at 30 minutes. That's not bad, but... There's no words here, because this guy's dead. Apparently my E didn't go off. Yeah, I've got some weird lag going on here. There's definitely something there. Who knows? Whatever. That wasn't the reason I missed the spear. I missed the spear because I'm a dumbass, but I had some weird, like, combo missing, and he's gonna probably try to wither me in a second. That landed. Yep, that's goodbye. Nasus. So the reason I walked out backwards is I wanted to drop Power Aggro onto Jace, but apparently he just wasn't feeling it. Whatever. We'll give Jace the attack speed buff, and we'll head up. We'll head back. I'm not going to be able to do much here because I'm too low health. So the rest of my team can do plenty. Maybe we won't head back. Maybe since Vi's sticking around bottom for some reason, we can continue to push. Although we've got no minions, it's probably risky. Vi will be here in a second. We've got 5 seconds to push this in and put pressure on it. The enemy Cassiopeia's probably going to be a bit of a threat. And he's got a good ult opportunity here. I don't want to give her a 5-man ult. I want to make sure I'm at least away from one of my teammates. Let me get tower for free. Sweet. We're going to protect the pen. That was a good Annie stun. No! Get out of here. Jerks. Do I have a blue buff? Maybe I have a blue buff. Oh crap, moly. Oh, baby! Dang it, I almost got them all. I don't think I could have comboed her out there, though. That was close, though. Good stuff. I mean, I'm kind of fed. You can't give me props when I'm that big. I'll take it. We got almost the inhibitor. We got the tower, though. And then we can push the inhibitor next push. And we also traded fairly evenly. We actually ended up ahead in that, I think. Because I know my AD carry got away. I think Sona got away. I'm not sure. But honestly, it was just 280 carries left, worst case, which is pretty good. How do I deal with my streaming problem? I'm actually in a completely different apartment now. So for the next couple of weeks, I'll be in a different apartment. So I didn't really solve the streaming problem. I'm just in a different location. Yeah, I was just like, please don't take blue, dude. You don't use blue. What are you doing? Come on, Renekton. He's 2-3-2. If he had thrown any like harass back at me, I would have been like, Renekton, you annoying fuck. Because he's the one who's been spamming like, help gank, please do something, and like overextending and just being a general nuisance. Let's see if he's starting to build some magic resist. Renekton's being kind of dumb. I'll help him out though, because you know, when you got an idiot on your team, you gotta make sure that he's not so dumb that you lose the game. But yeah, Renekton went pure damage. No, he didn't. Wow, he went this weird build. What? He didn't finish anything. This is something you should never do. You shouldn't build half items. Always finish the full items. Get out of here. So he never finished a single item. He's got all of these half built, aside from his boots, which means he's got to be significantly weaker than most people in this game. No, Renekton, you butt! Dude! I just saved his life and he wasted it. Wow, I hate this Renekton so much. He pretty much goes all in. I save his life by forcing Vi off of him, and then he runs away right away, and then wastes it all. What a jerk. Oh, I hate this guy so much. Not only was he just annoying in the early game, then he screws me over in the late. What a butt. Rip. Ripperoni's team. So that would be me being dead equals everybody loses. Painful, but I think we'll be alright. We could potentially throw this, but it looks like Nasus still got pretty minimal magic resist. He's just got a Spectres. I can finish that out into, I can finish my Banshees probably before he finishes out his Spectres. Eh, maybe not. It's a toss-up here. He's farming pretty poorly though for a Nasus. I'm almost, what am I, 20 CS below him? That's pretty close to his. I'm gonna put this in my mid cycle there. The biggest thing that's impacting my ability to kill people here is I have pretty low magic penetration. I think I have magic penetration in my runes. Yeah, I do. But I don't have very much overall across the board. I don't have my boots for magic penetration, so really I'm pretty weak. Now we can sweep for wards here. There's clearly a ward in here, or not. I'm not gonna stick around for this Cassiopeia to get some free low on me. Get out of here! I was gonna say, I swear to goodness gracious, Jace, if you just ran into me with that explosion on you, I'd have been mad. She's like, hey, you know what? I got some damage I can just share with you for fun. Why is... No, no, stay here, stay here, stay here, please. What are you doing? You are the definition of not smart. We could lose this game. There's a pretty significantly high chance that the rest of this team just doesn't understand. The enemy team does have a really great scaling, and we've got Renekton and Jace just running into them left and right. I can't fight that. What's up, Christian Messias? How you doing? We should just force a Baron here. Man, I hate... The thing that bothers me more than anything else in this game is when people continuously make the stupid decisions and they start trying to make calls. Like, Jace, you just ran into the enemy's team's fucking entire team and got rocked. Oh, maybe we should consider Baron. Like, oh, really? And he's denying me. Do not take. Do not take. Do not take. Do not fucking take it. Do not... No. Bad. I will murder you. I wanted that for two things. One, I wanted the blasting wand, and two, I also wanted the experience at level 15. There's clearly a ward here. Not smart, people. Didn't even sweep for Vi. So dumb. Something I don't know where... Now I know where Cassiopeia is. She was top lane. I was hesitant to walk into that brush face first because there could have been a Cass just waiting to ult me. But there wasn't a Cass because she showed top. But oftentimes what you'll see is whenever I walk into a Fog of War and there's a Cassiopeia or a Nunu on the enemy team, I'll end up running towards a brush and then I'll juke it to find out if there's the slow put on me by Nunu, or I'll get the ult from Cassiopeia, but I won't get stunned. So that's a pretty common thing that I'll do, is I'll just juke any brush. What does it cost me? A half a second to make sure that I don't get wrecked by somebody with insane ridiculousness. If she gets a good stun off, she can probably 100 to 0 me pretty quickly, despite me having an Abyssal Scepter. Just because that's how Cassiopeia is. 2-8, but she's got poop levels of damage, and by poop I mean the opposite of poop, like diamond levels of damage. Could you imagine if you could convert poop to diamond? I don't know why I said that. I don't think anything would be different. Diamond would probably have lower level or lower value, but oh my goodness gracious, are they really, guys? Please. They're gonna blame me. Guarantee it. They're gonna be like, Nidalee, why aren't you grouped? It's all your fault. Like, dude. You guys just ran into their whole team. Yep, there is the blame on the group. Shut up, dude. Y'all got freaking caught. It was Sona who died first, then Caitlyn, then Jace. Or then Renekton, then Jace. They can't do anything about against Baron. Buffed minions. I'm just gonna split bot because unfortunately for me, my team doesn't know how to not get wrecked. Like I said earlier, we were in a huge lead and now we're starting to throw it pretty hard. There's a big chance we could lose this. I don't want to lose this. I'm not gonna defend that. That's a waste of my time. No one's actually gonna push it. Hello, is this tower? It's full health. I don't want to get shot out or destroyed by Annie, but I do want to keep pressure here. Oh my goodness. The level of what the frick? Dude, please. You're welcome. Jesus. Why do these guys insist on diving the enemy team? I don't get it. Whatever. He wants to get wrecked by Caitlyn ulti, that's his prerogative. You're welcome. That should be game over. Unless for some reason the entire team runs away. Alright, interesting. Taking a dragon here is kind of a waste. We don't really have any purpose for it. The extra movement speed is nice, but it doesn't do much. Like, we have all their stuff down. We don't need to kite the enemy team out, we just need to force the fight and take the win. So I'm gonna go pick up the Void Staff. They can clear this thing without me, they don't need me. I'm gonna go pick up the Void Staff, upgrade my boots, and then potentially swap this out for Rel and Omicron. Upgrade my boots to these, and then pick up Elixir of Sorcery. But man, Team Arone, please Arone. They just keep doing these crazy aggressive things. Well, I can probably just backdoor the Nexus if I need to. I don't want to have to do that, but I might have to do that. Again, do not walk into random Fog of War brushes when you have no vision on the enemy team. Just don't do it. Don't give in to the pressure. You don't want to get dunked by a random Cassiopeia ult or a Nasus Wither and then all of a sudden lose a bunch of towers because you're the one person on your team that you have any chance of defending stuff with. There's an Annie here. If he had gone in on her, she was dead. She's out of the fight. Oh my goodness. So broken. She could have ulted me there. She should have actually. That would have been a great move by Vi. There we go. Beautiful. GG, well played. Alright, so that'll be our last game of replacements. Let's see where we get placed, boys. Let's find out. Apparently I turned off all chat. Oh, I haven't turned on all chat. What the heck? Is that client-side based, or is that... I think that's client-based. So, okay, I placed into gold 3. That's pretty decent for 9-1. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching. That was the final placements. That was pretty decent. If only I didn't lag out of that game previous to this one, I might have been 10-0. But there's not much you can do about it. I'm still pretty content with that. And I'm going to go play some more games, but I'll upload this one to my YouTube later. Thanks for those of you who are watching the stream, though. I'm not going to stop playing right now. I'll probably play one more. But I hope that was that decent? Like, were there any glitches? Or did the stream look weird at all? Let me see. I need to figure out how to fix this. Let's go into a custom game. Oh, I forgot to report Renekton. Dang it. I'm dumb. Jazz Boyd's game.
They will fear the wild.
Stream was fine. Was it a little compressed though? There were black bars around it and everything. Let me switch this to windowless or borderless. Video, full screen, borderless. Oh, that's so ugly. The whole stream is surrounded by a black rectangle. That's not normal. Let me try and fix this real quick.